Our environment. Learning about food chains and webs, ozone and its depletion and garbage management. Food chains and webs. We have formed a series of organisms feeding on one another. This series or organisms taking part at various biotic levels form a food chain. Each step or level of the food chain forms a trophic level. The autotrophs or the producers are at the first trophic level. They fix up the solar energy and make it available for heterotrophs or the consumers. The herbivores or the primary consumers come at the second. Small carnivores or the secondary consumers at the third. And larger carnivores or the tertiary consumers form the fourth trophic level. We know that the food we eat acts as a fuel to provide us energy to do the work. Thus, the interaction among various components of the environment involves flow of energy from one component of the system to another. The autotrophs capture the energy present in sunlight and convert it into chemical energy. This energy supports all the activities of the living world. From autotrophs, the energy goes to the heterotrophs and decomposers. When one form of energy is changed to another, some energy is lost to the environment in forms which cannot be used again. Firstly, the flow of energy is unidirectional. The energy that is captured by the autotrophs does not revert back to the solar input, and the energy which passes to the herbivores does not come back to autotrophs. Another interesting aspect of food chain is how unknowingly some harmful chemicals enter our bodies through the food chain. These chemicals are either washed down into the soil or into the water bodies. From the soil, these are absorbed by the plants along with water and minerals. This is one of the ways in which they enter the food chain, as these chemicals are not degradable. This phenomenon is known as biological magnification. This is the reason why our food grains such as wheat and rice, vegetables and fruits, and even meat contain varying amounts of pesticide residues. They cannot always be removed by the washing or other means. We are an integral part of the environment. Changes in the environment affect us, and our activities change the environment around us, that is, depletion of the ozone layer. Ozone, that is O3, is a molecule formed by three atoms of oxygen. While O2, which we normally refer to as oxygen. Ozone is a deadly poison, however, at the higher levels of the atmosphere. It shields the surface of the earth from ultraviolet, that is UV, radiation from the sun. Ozone at the higher levels of the atmosphere is a product of UV radiation acting an oxygen, O2, molecule. The higher energy UV radiations split apart some molecular oxygen, that is O2, into free oxygen, that is nascent oxygen, atoms. This decrease has been linked to synthetic chemicals like chlorofluorocarbons, that is CFCs, which are used as refrigerants and in fire extinguishers. Visit any town or city and we are sure to find heaps of garbage all over the place. We are sure to find the place littered with empty food wrappers. Improvements in our lifestyle have resulted in great amounts of waste material generation, with more and more things we use becoming disposable. Changes in packaging have resulted in much of our waste becoming non-biodegradable. Earlier, tea in trains was served in plastic glasses, which had to be returned to the vendor, which led to disposable problems. Some time back, kullads, that is, disposable cups made of clay, were suggested as an alternative which resulted in the loss of the fertile topsoil. Summary: there is a loss of energy as we go from one tropic level to the next. This limits the number of tropic levels in a food chain. Human activities have an impact on the environment. The use of chemicals like chlorofluorocarbons have endangered the ozone layer. Since the ozone layer protects against the ultraviolet radiation from the sun, this could damage the environment. So that is all in this lesson. The disposal of the waste we generate is causing serious environment problems. Let us reduce the waste we generate and save the environment. Till then, keep learning.